Graham was the one who said, like, next album, I want to write my own lyrics, I want to write my own melodies, because Michael Foss was writing for Graham.
Michael had said, okay, we need two songs for each singer.
Ronnie Romero. Get that right.
They did a great job. They did their vocals perfectly.
Dougie took two songs straight away, and so he was covered. And then Michael wrote three to my music, wrote three lyrics melodies, and every time all three songs had the low voice of Gary in it. I gave one of the songs to get Graham Bonnet, and I had to say to Graham, Graham, I'm sorry, but this has to be an old song, because Gary is the one with the low, beautiful, bluesy voice. It needs to be sung by Gary.
And I wrote the lyrics, and I wrote the harmonies, and I wrote the lead vocal tracks for these, for the range of the singers, like the Gary singing the, like, all this time long ago, you have to understand, the boy became a rock star with a guitar in his hand. And so he sang the lower parts, and we had Dan Dougie with the strong vocals, and Graham with his powerful vocals, and we had all the blends from all the singers.
And then Michael comes up and says, like, I have a great idea. I have worked with Ronnie Romero, and he would be very suitable for this song. And I said, really? Well, why don't you ask him? And so he asked him, and he said he would be delighted, right? He said he would be more than happy to do so, and it turned out great, you know?
I was on tour like half a year ago with the band Corleone, where Ronnie is actually singing with that band, and I played support act with my band Mad Max, and so we got in touch and said, well, we changed telephone numbers, and I said, hey, Ronnie, if there's any chance to work together on a topic, would love to get in touch with you. And that was the perfect timing. I said, hey, Ronnie, would you like to sing on the new Shankar album? I said, count me in. I said, I send you the files tomorrow. And he did that, bang, bang, bang.
It's a great singer, you know, and so it worked out really good that way.
Now he was, he's still with Ritchie Blackmore, singing for Ritchie Blackmore. And it's such a funny story because of the other singers, like, first you have Graham Bonnet, who started with Rainbow, and then joined Shankar, and Dougie White as well. And so it's funny, and now you've got, like, Ronnie joining Mr. Blackmore and then hopping into the Shank camp. It's fun.
People said, like, Michael, I can't even get on with one singer. How can you get on with four singers, you know? And I said, I don't know. It just is what it is. You know, I'm not doing anything. I'm just being myself. Everybody's being themselves.
Well, this time I didn't have to travel that much. We were just focusing here in the studio. I had Dougie White singing the vocals in here. I had Gary Barden here singing the vocals. And Chris Glenn was laying down his bass here. So the Graham Bonnet's vocals have been recorded in Los Angeles, and so was Robin McAuley recorded in Los Angeles. And I think they all did a proper job recording in the recording studios and somewhere else. That was great. Living it up, rock steady, living it up, we're keeping the